in Fleet Street, that's in London town, when King Charlie wore the crown, there lived a man of great renown. 'Twas Sweeney Todd the barber. One shave from him and you'd want no more. You'd feel his razor sharp, then tumble wallop through the floor and wake up playing a harp and singing Sweeney Todd the barber. By God, we were better than the play. Sweeney Todd the barber, I'll polish him off, he used to say. His clients through the floor would slope, but he had no fear of the hangman's rope. Dead men can't talk with their mouths full of soap, said Sweeney Todd the barber. Now underneath the shop, it's true, where the bodies tumble through, there lived a little widow who loved Sweeney Todd the barber. She made her living by selling pies. Her meat pies were a treat, chock full of meat and such a size, 'cause she was getting the meat from Mr. Sweeney Todd the barber. By God, we were better than the play. Sweeney Todd the barber, I'll polish him off, he used to say. And many's the poor young orphan lad had the first square meal he'd ever had. A hot meat pie made out of his dad from Sweeney Todd the barber. It was Saturday night in old Sweeney Todd's shop, and his customers sat in a row, while Sweeney behind a screen shaved some poor mug, and his sweetheart made pies down below. Though none were aware it were cut prices there, they were rolling up in twos and threes, and his foot was quite sore pressing knob on the floor, and his voice went from saying, "Next, please!" First a swell took the chair. He said, "Ha ha, my man, just a shave and a perfume shampoo, for I've just got engaged." Sweeney just pressed the knob and said, "There, now it's all fallen through." Then a bookmaker said, with his mouth full of soap, "They're all backing favourites today, so I'll bet I'll go down." Sweeney said, "So you will," and he did. He went down straight away. But what rotten luck, the darn trap went and stuck, for the hinge he'd forgotten to grease. And a customer there started calling out police, just as Sweeney was saying, "Next, please." Yes, he ran to the door and he shouted out, "Police!" He called police 9 times or 10. But no policeman arrived, and a very good reason. The police weren't invented by then. But up came the brave Bow Street runners, hoorah! And he had to let many a pie burn, while they dragged him to quad, and next day Sweeney Todd was condemned to be switched off at Tyburn. And there on the gibbet he hangs in his chains, and they do say a little black crow made a sweet little nest in old Sweeney Todd's whiskers, and sang as he swang to and fro. Sweeney Todd the barber, by God, we were better than a play. Sweeney Todd the barber, they buried him underneath the clay. And old Nick calls him from his grave, shouting, "Wake up, Sweeney, I want a shave." And Mrs. Nick wants a permanent wave from Sweeney Todd.